Rebuilding or reconceiving refugee protection is really urgently needed because the numbers of displaced people have overwhelmed the capacity of the existing system to deal with the issue that's before it.
Well, it means that we have a crisis in the world. We have 65 million forcibly displaced persons, 21 million of them are refugees. And those numbers are increasing year by year.
The crisis in terms of receiving these people, the crisis in terms of addressing their needs, is only a crisis because it's left to a very small number of countries to deal with it. To the extent that all 193 member states, or the vast majority of them, could step up to the mark and work better together, this is a problem that is not at all insurmountable, that could be dealt with in a way that is both humane and where we would realize the full benefits of people moving.
For the migrants, specifically, what I'm hoping and what IOM would like to see come out is a recognition that migration is overall a positive force in the world, and that we need to be recognizing the agency and the contributions of migrants and finding ways to really move from this fear of migrants and migration to a place where we're facilitating safe, regular, and orderly migration.
I think the basic metric is to turn the tide on the growth in the refugee population and the forcibly displaced population, but that involves public education, it involves education of policymakers, and it involves really, really good ideas that can be implemented by states, by the international community, by local communities, by the refugees themselves.
Refugees change communities, and they change them for good. So if we think of refugees differently, by providing them with education, they can go as far as to become doctors, lawyers, nurses, and the people who will be taking care of the rest of the community.
Yo creo que el público no sabe, no conoce lo que es ser un refugiado. O ser una pátrida, o ser un migrante que huye.
Look, at the end of the day, the numbers indicate these are poor people. These are often people who do not have the right to work, but who at the same time can contribute to economic progress, contribute to their own welfare. So it's that intersection between the head and the heart, the rights as well as the opportunities. The fact that at the end of the day, that person who's a refugee could be me.